Now the question is, how Oracle upgrades happen in a normal database? I'll talk about a standalone database where ASM and grid is not there. Normal file system installation. See, if we have a single database, like this is ProtDB, no data guard configuration, okay? And this is normal standalone file system DB. So no ASM, no grid, it's a standalone database and it is onto normal file system. In this case, we have Oracle 11G. What we do is we install 12C in a new home and then we start the database via 12C home, the new 12C home, and then we'll upgrade the database, right? Now upgrades are of two types. You use DBUA, Database Upgrade Assistant, or manual upgrade. Now manual upgrade is little tedious and it really takes a lot of efforts of a DBA, but with DBUA, it's just like a graphical interface. You input your credentials and upgrade will be done. There is a problem with DBU. Let's take your upgrade fails in between. You cannot use DBU again. You have to go with the manual method. That's the problem with DBU. Okay, but I don't think you figure out or you see issues so frequently with DBUA. Even it is so comfortable, like you can go and perform the upgrades with DBUA. Should not be a problem. In our case, we will be using DBUA. Why? Because we have two Oracle home, grid home, database home, and then we have data guard configuration. So it is very complex. And if we go with manual method, there are so many steps that, you know, you might get confused. So I myself forcefully not going with manual method, will be going with DBUA method just to simplify the upgrade process, right? So this is how upgrades happen in a normal standalone database. Now how upgrades happen in a normal standalone, file system database with data guard. Let's take, we have ProtDB and then we have ProtDB underscore ST. This is still, we are not having grid, okay? Only Oracle database we are having. There was a data guard configuration from 11G to 11G. And then we have to upgrade both the databases to 12C. So how it is done? Actually, I'll take a new session. Right, on this, we have 11G home. We have installed 12C. Okay, we did not install 12C. We'll go with the configuration first. And then we have standby database where it is also 11G. So this is ProtDB and ProtDB underscore ST. Perfect. This is the data guard configuration which is running fine on 11G database and no ASM, no grid. So how do you upgrade a normal data guard configuration? Always remember, in a data guard configuration, first standby is upgraded and then you upgrade the primary. So what we will do is we'll install the 12C over here. We'll start the database via 12C home. Start 11G DB via 12C. And then we'll start only the MRP. Why we are starting MRP? I'll come to this point later, okay? And then once we have upgraded the standby to 12C, now it's time to upgrade the primary. So on primary, we'll install the 12C, then we'll start DBUA. With DBUA, our DB will be upgraded from 11G to 12C. While the DBUA is upgrading, your logs are still being shipped over the network to the standby, and because your MRP is running, automatically the upgrade redo that is generated onto the primary, that will be shipped to the standby. So those redo will be applied to the 12C database, and then automatically your 11G will be upgraded to 12C. we don't need to specifically start DBUA over here, and we do not do it because the redo that is generated on the primary when you initiate DBUA, the same redo is applied by MRP on the standby. So why do we need to upgrade standby separately? We don't do it. So this is how in general upgrade process happen in a data guard environment. For your understanding, I'll specify the things once again how it is done. Now we have prod DB, and then we have standby. Both the databases are on 11G. I mean, this applies to any upgrade, okay? Let's take if it is a interim upgrade like 11.201 to 11.204, something like that. Even for that, it is applying. Now, this data guard configuration is working fine. Perfect, 1-to-1. What we do is we install 12C, start DB via 12C home, start DB via 12C home, and then start MRP. Only two steps, nothing more than that. In the primary, we'll install the 12C, and then we'll initiate DBUA via the 12C home, and then 11G will be upgraded to 12C. The redo that is generated via DBUA is running. This redo will be auto transferred to standby. Because MRP is running, even your database onto the standby will be upgraded to 12C. Now once upgrade is done, your configuration will look like this. This won't work. From 12C primary database, it will be shipping logs to 12C standby database. Later on, you can delete the 11G home. So this is how upgrade happen in a normal, data guard configuration. But when we look at our configuration, we have already complicated it by installing grid and ASM, right? So how we are going to perform upgrade with the database where grid is also involved? Okay, now I will talk about single standalone database where you have grid and a database. So standalone DB with ASM. So we don't have a data guard configuration over here, okay? So we have grid home, and then we have DB home. Perfect. Our grid is also 11G, and our DB home is also 11G. This is primary or some database prod DB. Perfect. In this configuration, when you have grid and when you have DB home, always you have to upgrade the grid first. So there is a compatibility factor of grid, that grid is always compatible to any database which is lower than or equal to the same version of grid. When we say lower than or equal to, see in this case we have 11G grid and 11G database, so it is compatible, perfectly fine. Now when we upgrade the grid software from 11G to 12C, still our database version is lower than grid, right? So 11G is less than 12C. That even in this case your grid will support. So any database can run on a grid software which is greater than or equal to the same version, and that's why we upgrade the grid first to 12C, and our 11G database will still continue to run on 12C grid software. Then we proceed to upgrade the DB home by installing, we'll install 12C binaries, and then will initiate DBUA. So this is how we are going to perform the upgrade. Now this is the case with the standalone DB with ASM, but how do we perform an upgrade where standalone DB is configured with ASM along with the data guard configuration, which is our scenario right now? So what is our scenario? Standalone DB with ASM in data guard configuration. This is our scenario. So now that we know how do we perform the upgrade for a standalone DB where ASM is not involved and where ASM is involved, we need to use both the concepts over here. So how are we going to perform the upgrade? See, we have the grid and we have the DB home, or I'll say Aura home. Okay, and then the same configuration we have on the standby. This is prod DB and then prod DB underscore ST. Again, we have the grid and then Aura home. So guys, okay, the data guard configuration is working fine. Current configuration is 11G. Now I'll ask you a few questions, okay? With our first concept, should we upgrade primary first or the standby first? So we upgrade the standby first, and in the standby we'll enable the MRP so that when we upgrade the primary, automatically redo from primary will upgrade the standby. Always remember, in a data guard configuration we'll upgrade the standby first because client will continue to talk with the primary. Okay, so with this data guard configuration we have to upgrade the standby first. That is our first goal. Now forget about this one. Look at grid and Oracle home. When we have grid and when we have Oracle home, which one do we upgrade first? So we will have to upgrade grid first. First upgrade, and then we'll have to upgrade the DB home. Now once prod DB underscore ST is upgraded, we'll have to upgrade the primary. On primary we again have grid home and Oracle home. So which one do we upgrade first? Grid home. So this will be our third upgrade, and then this will be fourth upgrade. Now can you see how the upgrade process works? Even though this is our primary, the Oracle home, but this will be upgraded last when all the components are upgraded. So two important things to learn over here. When in data guard configuration, in DG config, you always upgrade the upgrade standby first. Perfect. And the second one is always upgrade grid before DB. Now with these two concepts, we have to first upgrade the standby, and on standby we'll initially upgrade the grid, then we'll upgrade the Oracle home. After the upgrade we will initiate the MRP process, and then we'll leave the server. We'll come to the primary server, we'll upgrade the grid home, we'll upgrade the Oracle home, we'll start the DB UA, and once we started the DB UA, automatically whatever redo is generated, that will be transferred onto the standby, and standby database will also be upgraded.